This video presents several editing modes of the offset modifiers in Profile Manager. On the screen, you can see a predefined profile in the Profile Editor. You can activate the offset modifiers in the modifiers list of Profile Manager, or simply click a gray offset dimension in the Editor window to activate and select it. Click the dimension end, move to another node, and click on it to reassign the dimension anchor. As you can see, the direction of the dimension is also changed. Let's see how you can add additional edges to an offset dimension. You can link several edges to a single dimension. Hover your cursor over the dimension or an assigned edge of the active modifier and click the appearing Add Remove Edge grip. As you move the cursor, the eligible edges become highlighted in blue. Click on an edge to choose it, and then click to define its direction. Now choose the downward direction, same as the other flange edge has. After storing the changes, you can see that the flange edges can move together. Let's rename modifier, as this now defines the web height. In the modifier list, double-click its name, delete the existing, and enter the new one in its place. In the next shot, you can now learn how to define two connected modifiers. Let's create a new modifier with the name Flange Thickness. Define the bottom flange edge to offset edge and anchor it to the node of the upper side of the bottom flange. The flange thickness offset dimension is anchored to the upper flange edge, which itself is another web height modifier. So, if the upper flange is offset, the flange thickness dimension also moves. However, the flange thickness can be adjusted separately. Let's see now how we can add the additional dimensions to an existing offset modifier. Select the offset gridder modifier. Click the Add Dimension icon. On the other side, click on the sloped edge to choose it. Set the same direction and click again to place it. Its dimension length is the same as the existing one defined in the modifier. As you can see, in result, a single modifier can offset and control two separately anchored edges. You can also change the directions of the existing modifiers. Let's select, for example, the web height. Notice, if the dimension is perpendicular to the offset edge, the arrowhead of the edge cannot be modified. It's always the same as the direction of the dimension. However, the direction of the later added edge can be changed. When hovering above the black arrowhead, the other direction appears in gray. Click to accept this direction. In this case, the directions of the two edge offsets are opposite to each other on the placed profile. When adding an additional dimension, the change of direction can be achieved by turning over the static dimension. In result, there will be edge offsets in opposite directions. The dimension can be set not only perpendicular, but slant as well. Let's see an example for this. Create a new modifier by defining the two end nodes of the slanted edge. Click the Add Remove Edge grip. Three options appear for turning the dimension direction. To horizontally between two points, vertically, or we can even return to the original direction. To remove an offset edge, select and activate the offset modifier. Click the appearing Add Remove Edge grip. Hover your cursor over the edge that is to be removed or over its dimension. When it turns red, click to delete. Please note, when all dimensions in a modifier are deleted, the modifier gets a warning notice in Profile Manager. If you want to remove an offset modifier, select it and click the Delete Modifier button. The selected offset modifier with all its offset dimensions and assigned edges will be deleted as well. In this video clip, we redefined dimension ends, added edges to dimensions, and added additional dimensions to offset modifier. You could also learn to connect two modifiers, how to change directions, and remove an edge or modifier.